Jeffrey Lin here to talk about car air purifiers on this episode of Fifth Gear. The regular car air filter just isn't enough. And last year I learned about the Tesla Bioweapons Defense Mode.
The net effect of the air filtration system is that you have air cleanliness levels which are comparable to a hospital operating room in the car. You just press the Bioweapon Defense Mode button. This is a real button.
So I looked into how to do that because actually no other car has that and no other car can do that. And more importantly, none of the air purifiers that's currently on the market can provide this kind of hospital grade or clean room type of clean air protection from the outside. So I went ahead and hacked together my own car air purification system that's hospital grade, and I'll show you guys how to do it in this video.
Hit it!
That's what I'm talking about!
Wait!
Okay now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boy.
Hey, it's Jeffrey Lin. So what kind of air purification system is good enough for someone like me with multiple immune chronic illnesses like severe asthma, severe allergies, and eczema? I'm literally allergic to everything on the planet. There's nothing I've tested for that's not significantly off the charts. Nothing in the planet that's not toxic to me. So I looked into what hospitals use for their surgery rooms and isolation rooms, and they all use what Tesla uses for their bioweapons defense mode. What they use is the HEPA system, which is high efficiency particulate air. And it's probably one of the most common ones that you've heard of. Basically what HEPA does is it's able to capture 99.97% of anything that's out there, and it could capture everything and filter these things out from the air, everything down to 0.3 microns. That's about the size of large viruses. And actually, HEPA filters are very efficient when it's under 0.3 microns as well. So it's only that 0.3 microns where it's a little bit inefficient, but at 99.97% efficiency, it's basically 100%. So the reason why hospitals and Tesla use HEPA and none of these other newer technologies that you've heard of is because HEPA is tried and true, and the other newer technologies or even ionic air purification systems, those actually produce things like ozones that are pollutants. So ionizing air purification systems have been around actually since probably for like 20, 30 years or longer. I've tried it as a kid and immediately my asthma got much worse and I was constantly choking because of the ozone that these ionic purification systems release as a byproduct. So it's not a fluke that hospitals and Tesla chose to use the HEPA system. It's because HEPA actually is very high tech, the way the HEPA filters are manufactured. There's a lot of technology, micro technology, nanotechnology that goes into them for both like the structure of the filter and just the way it's constructed, and also the kind of fiberglass material that goes into it. So you should feel very safe just going with a HEPA filter. There are a lot of HEPA-like filters out there that try to trick you into buying them, but you just want to make sure that you want the true HEPA filter, and you also make sure you're seeing the 99.97% efficiency and also that 0.3 micron size that it's able to capture. So let's take a look at this chart. It'll capture viruses, tobacco smoke, other smoke, bacteria, household dust, pet dander, mold spores, and pollen. So there's another part to HEPA filters. It's actually the pre-filter that's made of activated carbon or charcoal. the pre-filter is actually the ones that filter out the bigger particles like pollen and dust, even like skin when my eczema is really bad and peels. It's really the pre-filter, the carbon activated filter, that filters out chemicals and odors and volatile organic compounds that I discussed before, where when it gets hot, even inside the car, the leather and the plastics will start releasing chemicals called VOCs or volatile organic compounds, sort of like when you're cooking something and it gets really hot and you start smelling the smell. Well, all the leather in the car and the plastics will start releasing VOCs or volatile organic compounds. They'll be very dangerous to the human body. So the pre-filter will capture all of that. I made an in-depth video about air purifiers and explaining how HEPA works. So I'll definitely suggest that you go check that out and review it so you understand what I'm talking about here. But I want to start with the conventional car air purifiers that I've tried that doesn't work. So all of these car air purifiers that I've seen are small ionic air purifiers that you can just plug into your car. And there's a couple of problems with that. First, I already explained that ionic air purifiers, they actually create a lot of ozone pollutants that will make you sick. So if you're sensitive at all, you cannot use ionic air purifiers. Any kind of ozone is very dangerous to your health. And the ozone that these ionic air purifiers create can also damage your nose and your senses and your airway, so that you can't detect when there's actually dangerous chemicals and ozone around. So I would actually stay away from basically any kind of car air purifiers that you see on the market. Most car air purifiers are ionic air purifiers because the car just simply can't produce enough power to run a normal HEPA filter. HEPA air filters are very dense. That's why they can capture 0.3 microns and smaller viruses. It's because all the fibers are very, very close together. And so it's very, very hard to move enough air through that. You need a very large engine and fan to do that. And so that's why I guess Tesla is the only one that's able to do that, because it actually had that built into their fan and their engine. That brings me to option number two, which is to buy a HEPA filter that fits into your car's filter slot. And certain cars have that option, but it doesn't come from the manufacturer. There are third-party manufacturers that have HEPA filters for certain models of cars. But because the car's air filter frame isn't built to handle HEPA air filters, when it starts trying to pull too much air through it, there'll be gaps on the side where the smoke and the pollutants from outside will actually go around the HEPA filter and still get into your car cabin. So you're not actually getting the protection from the HEPA filter. So unless you have a Tesla where the car frame and the whole engine and the system is built to handle a HEPA filter, you can't actually incorporate it into the car itself. So that brings me to my option, which is hacking together a HEPA filter for your car. It's actually pretty easy. I just took a regular desktop HEPA filter. This is the Honeywell HPA020. It works for like small dorm rooms and probably like little kids' rooms. But it's more than enough capacity to work for a car or a van. And instead of plugging it into your car, you can just get one of these power banks that's designed to work with your laptop when you're traveling. So these are high capacity. And I guess you can buy even bigger ones, like mini generators, that you can use. But I got this one because this one is TSA approved size, so I can bring this with me while traveling and power my laptop. So all you gotta do is plug in the HEPA filter into this power bank and can turn on the power bank. You'll hear the HEPA filter starting to run. I'll link to both this power bank and the HEPA air filter in the links below. But this specific power bank can power the HEPA air filter for about 2 hours on high, and it can power it for about three and a half hours on medium, and it could power it for about 6 hours when I have the HEPA air purifier on low. Can work for an all-day trip if I wanted to. Just gotta remember to also have your car on inside air recycle air mode, so you're not drawing in more air, more pollutant air, more smoke from the outside. The reason I got the Honeywell HPA 020 HEPA air filter is because it's part of the same series of HEPA air filters that I reviewed in the air purifier video. They're all from Honeywell. They all use the same HEPA filter, so I can just buy the same air filters and the same carbon pre-filter for the ones I use in my house, as well as this one for the car. They're all the same size, they're all interchangeable. So the last thing to remember about using this HEPA air purifier on the car is it's still not gonna be perfectly like a hospital clean room. It's still not gonna be what you can get with the Tesla Model S with the Bioweapons Defense Mode. So most cars don't have a complete perfect air seal from the outside. So even when you are using internal recycled air, some air from the outside does get in. And most of the times you can't tell just because the amount that's getting in is so low. But for those of us that are very sensitive, that do have allergies and inflammations, you know, we might get fatigued and tired or get nausea or brain fog. But you can definitely tell that most cars don't have a perfect air seal when you pass by something with a very strong odor, such as skunks or sulfur. That's something that you can't really fix. You just try to move as much air through the cabin as possible. And when you see videos of the Tesla Bioweapons Defense Mode, when that's on, you see the inside recycle air on full blast. So just remember, when you're in your car, if you don't have a HEPA air filter, you know, turn on recycle air, internal inside air, and have that on full blast to clean out the cabin air as fast as possible. So even if something dirty is coming in, if there's smoke or pollen or allergies coming in, if the recycled air is being recycled fast enough, hopefully it can clean out some of that before it gets into your lungs. But even when you have the HEPA air filter, try to do that. Just have recycled air and have both a HEPA air filter and your car fan on high, and just recycle that over and over. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Remember to hit the subscribe button and comment below. Let me know if you're able to use this setup. And remember, you don't have to use the specific HEPA air purifier that I use. You can do this combo of having a HEPA filter with a power bank or a little mini generator for your car. And let me know how that works for you.